Blessed Monday afternoon mga ka-Itulay, sa ating mga parents, teachers, and of course sa ating mga BioStar students na na-miss ko last week. Welcome sa Itulay Online Tutorial General Biology 2. And this is Tutor Tina from San Lorenzo Ruiz Senior High School, SDO, Pasig. Kamusta po ang lahat? Kamusta, Tutor Easter?
Yes, Tutor Tina, na-miss ka namin nung last Monday. At I'm sure talaga na-miss ka ng ating mga BioStar students and partner schools. Isang mahusay na hapon po sa inyong mga kaitulay, mga BioStar students at mga bioactive school and teachers po. I am Mrs. Easter, Tutor Easter B. Borallo from Horacio de la Costa High School, SDO, Caloocan.
Okay, yan. So, bali tutuloy natin ngayong week, no? Dahil na-miss natin last 2 weeks. Okay, so today is June 6 at nasa week 6 na po tayo, 6-6, no? Mid-year mid-year sale na. Nakapag-add to cart ka na ba, Tutor Easter?
Mamaya, okay. Pagdating natin, pagtapos ng episode.
Oo nga. So, for this week, bago tayo mag-add to cart at mag-buy now, no, ang idadiscuss natin for this week is about, again, another organ system, musculoskeletal system. Okay, so ang usual reminder muna natin before we begin is also sinabi na ni Cap Madge kanina, i-prepare natin ang ating pen and paper, ang ating mga gadgets, and of course, ready our mind and para makinig at matuto this afternoon.
Sik-sik-lig-lig tayo ng discussion, Tutor Tina. Sik-sik-lig-lig tayo ng attendance check. So please write your name, grade and section, school and location, and name of your biology teacher, and please share our live stream, and please be respectful with our comments in our chat box.
Okay, so don't forget to share this Facebook or kung nanonood man kayo via YouTube. Okay, so ito na ang ating bioactive school of the week. So we still have, no, ito yung mga talagang sumusuporta sa atin since quarter 3. Padre Garcia National High School with Ma'am Ladeline Ducay, Jones Rural School, Ma'am Cheryl Gumpal Reyes. We have Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School, Ma'am Jen Melendres Pepito. We also have from Novaliches High School, Ma'am Jeanette Tamse, and then from Horacio de la Costa Senior High School, of course, our very own Tutor Easter, Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School, Ma'am Noraida A. Sally, and then Marawi Integrated National High School, Sir Jerwin na laging nanonood sa atin. Hello po, Sir Jerwin. We have San Mariano National High School, Mr. Nolly L. Balbin, and of course, from San Lorenzo Ruiz Senior High School, yours truly. Para naman sa ating BioStar students.
So, Tutor Tina, ito ang ating mga BioStar students of the week. So, Hannah Del Rosario, Daishi Vallejo, Luisa Joy Pua, Ainsley Lucia, Rosel Andohar, Elena Remorosa, Alan Mark De Jesus, Austin Enriquez, Michael Lutiva, Angelic Cagatiayon, John Wayne Prieto, and Almarie Macarayo. Yeah. And we have also another BioStar students of the week, Ayla Golosinda, Glidel Oplado, Iverson Infante, Edinburgh Royal, Lorraine Quinto, Frances Bayan, and Joshua Rimandiman. So, okay. Salamat mga BioStar students of the week. Ipagpatuloy ang pagpapanday ng kaalaman sa biology.
Yeah. Okay, napakarami nila, no? At unting-unti na lang ay nalalapit na ang ating pagtatapos. Okay, so balikan muna natin yung discussion last week sa about gas exchange na diniscuss sa atin ni Tutor Easter. Okay, so for our first one, so just type number one, ito ay, okay, all you have to do is to complete the missing word. Okay, so a type of respiration that uses oxygen to produce energy from food. Okay, so meron siyang letter A and then meron din siyang letter I. So just type number one, no, and then your answer, BioStar students.
Tutor Tina, we have an answer from, wow, Elena de Morosa, aerobic. From James Dio, aerobic, from Saavedra, Vilieno, Agbayani, Nutiva, aerobic. So what is the answer, Tutor Tina?
Okay, correct. It's aerobic respiration. Okay, so let's have the second one. Okay, so ito naman, this is the other name, yung picture, kung titingnan nyo, this is the other name of this tube. Okay, so a tube that carries air in and out of your lungs. Okay, so baka medyo naluluto sila, ano ba yan? Okay, so this is the other name of this tube. Ano kaya ito? That starts with letter T. Okay, so just type number two.
And your answer. Yan, we have an answer here from Golasinda, Miss Golasinda Traquea, from Elena Traquea, from Glyde Laplado Traquea, from Michael Lutiva Traquea, and all of them answered Traquea. Is it Traquea, Tutor Tina?
Okay, so trachea, so yung ating picture, wind plus pipe, okay, because the other name of our trachea is windpipe, okay, daana ng hangin. Let's go to number three and last one. And so, combine Hello, sir, lang din yeah. natin. Combine lang din natin yung pictures.
Yeah. Ah, so, wow. So, type number three. And okay, your answer.
These are cells that regulate the process of transpiration that is happening in the stomata. Okay, so ano kaya yan? So, i-combine
yeah,
lang natin yung pictures.
Here, Tutor Tina, KCTB. Guard cell.
Okay.
From Saavedra, guard cell. Mr. Andohar, guard cells. Okay? Okay. So, Tartina, what is our answer?
Okay, yes, correct. The correct answer is guard cells. Alright, very good. Bye-bye, star students. No, ready na. Makinig. So, ano ba ang ating most essential learning competency for week 6, Tutor Easter?
So our most essential learning competency for quarter 4, week 6, mga BioStar students, is to compare and contrast the following processes in plants and animals. So this is our last system to be discussed for this semester,
yes.
Which is the musculoskeletal system.
Okay, correct na, Tutor Easter. Last organ system na natin to. And titingnan natin kung ano ba yung counterpart ng musculoskeletal natin in plants. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so our musculoskeletal system, from the name itself, is composed of two systems. So what are these? We have the muscular system, and then we also have the skeletal system. And both of these systems work together to support and move the body. Okay, so marami actually silang functions, but the main functions of these two or combined system is to support and move the body. Okay, so let's start with skeletal system. So our skeletal system are made up of skeleton. And when we say skeleton, ano ba ang ibig sabihin nito? Okay, so the skeleton is any rigid structure that provides protective and supportive framework to organisms. It's because, no, Tutor Easter, pag naririnig natin yung word na skeleton, ang unang pumapasok sa isip natin, bones, okay? But
yes.
It doesn't work that way, no. Maraming it's any rigid structure, because later on makikita natin na merong mga protective and supportive framework ang ibang organisms, pero not necessarily they are bones. Okay. So, what are the functions of our skeletal system? So, for the first one is for the support. And our skeleton supports or holds up our body. Okay? So, everything else ay naka-attach sa ating skeleton. So if we try to compare it with building a house, okay, so we can consider it as a framework. Okay, so framework would be, let's say, steel bars or wood manyan, and everything else ay naka-attach na dun sa ating framework. So let's say the plumbing, the drywall, and so on, so sa building of houses. And aside from that, in terms of in animals naman, yung muscles, naka-attach sa bone, the skin, and all. Okay. And aside from that, no, it gives us also the sense of shape. Based lang, pag tinignan natin yung framework. So let's say here, no, we can say that this animal or the human is upright based on the arrangement of its skeleton. And we can also say that this animal, let's say lower forms of animals, four-legged siya, it's because of the arrangement of the skeleton. Okay, so let's go to the next function. And the next function of our skeletal system is for protection. And we can say that not every part of our body is equally protected. Okay, so it provides protection to the vital organs where it is most needed. Okay, so the most protected part of our body, yes, okay, the most protected part of our body is our brain. Diba, no, Tutor Easter, at na-discuss natin sa nervous system before that our brain is enclosed in what we call the skull or cranium, and no part of our brain is exposed. Diba? Walang spaces dyan na makakapa natin na merong bone, ay na merong brain, okay? So, next to the brain is the spinal cord. And the spinal cord is also protected with the bone. We call that the vertebral column. So, protected din siya entirely with the skeleton, with the bone. And these two, the brain and the spinal cord, comprises our CNS, or the central nervous system, which is very important. And if we try to compare it with the other parts of the body, let's say our heart and our lungs, it's also protected with our rib cage. Pero there are spaces, di ba? And then meron tayong sternum, the breastbone. Protected din siya, no? But it's not entirely like the brain and our spinal cord. So there are spaces in between the rib cage. Okay, so ayan. Also the abdomen part, wala na siyang bones, no, it's not covered anymore. Okay, so let's go to the third function of the skeleton. So unahin muna natin yung storage of minerals, specifically the calcium. So ang bones natin, it stores calcium, and we all know that calcium gives strength to our bones. So kung walang calcium or buwababang level ng calcium, nagiging porous yung buto natin, diba? And let's say bumababa yung level of calcium in the bloodstream, then the calcium that is stored in our bones could be released para ma-reach natin yung optimum level of blood of calcium na needed din sa ng katawan natin, or yung optimum level ng calcium na needed in the bloodstream. Okay? And then let's go to the fourth function. We have the production of blood cells, and we call that the hematopoiesis. So when we say blood cells, we are not only talking here of red blood cells, also white blood cells, platelets, and so on. So I have here a graph, not Tutor Easter, that shows here, ito yung sa X niya ay the horizontal line, ito yung age, we have the fetal months, meaning ito yung nasa loob pa tayo, nagde-develop pa lang tayo sa uterus ng ating mom, we are producing blood cells na, no? And then at birth, and then ito hanggang 70 years. And then we have the cellularity, ito yung percentage ng paggawa ng blood cells. And so wag na nating tingnan yung sa fetal years, because maraming iba't ibang organs na responsible for making the blood, no, blood cells. So let's observe here yung sa after we are born, so at birth, and then ano. So we can say here, natitingnan natin yung green corresponds with our tibia. Ito yung tibia natin, yung bone dito natin sa ating legs. And then we have the fibula. The tibia fibula yan. And then we have the femur. Ito yung longest nating bone here. And at birth, pinakamataas sila, no? And then during 20 and going 30, ayan, sa mga age natin ba yan, Tutor Easter? Okay, 20, 30 years old. Okay, so bumababa ng level at yan, no, at 40, nag 50, nagiging zero na siya. So this is because the bone marrow in this bones, tong tibia, specifically tibia and fibula, nagiging surrounded na siya, or fat na yung deposit niya, no, instead of the mag-produce pa ng blood cells. So ano na lang yung mga nagiging gumagawa or responsible ng blood cells natin at age 30, 40, yung mga adult years natin. We have the vertebra, and then the sternum, and then the ribs. So mostly yung the actual, mamaya tatbabaanin natin yun, the actual skeleton na lang yung responsible at bumababa na. Pero yung mga age, siguro na ating mga bi-star students, no, less than 20 or 20, yan. So ang pinakamataas pa sa kanila ay ang kanilang femur at ang... Okay, so ayan. So those are the functions of our skeletal system, no? Marami pa, but those are the main ones.
In addition to the hematopoiesis, the part of the bone that is responsible with the production of the red blood cells is your bone marrow.
Yes, so yun po
yung yung talaga, kaya nga, di ba, pag gusto natin mag-donate ng blood, 'di ba? Kailangan ano ma, ma ano yung ma-initiate o ma-ignite yung ating bone marrow to produce a new red blood cells. And also
yes,
your yellow marrow is the one also responsible with releasing other blood cells also.
Yes,
kaya makailangan talaga yun.
That's found in those bones, yes. So let's classify naman the types of skeleton. So we have the exoskeleton, the prefix exo means outside. And these are the bony structures that can be found externally. So in terms of vertebrae, ang mga exoskeleton natin are considered skin derivative, such as the dermis and the epidermis. So in the fish, we have the scales, then in amphibians, we have the claws, okay? And then, we have, for reptiles, we have scales, scutes. Okay, so yan yung mga exoskeleton that they have. Okay, next we have, for mammals, we have the nails. Okay, so nails ng mammals, the horns. Okay, those are the exoskeleton. And then, for aves or for birds, we have the feathers, the claws. Okay, so those are the exoskeleton of our birds. Okay, so let's go now to invertebrates. Okay, so for invertebrates, or these are the walang backbone, di ba? Okay, so we have here chitin. Okay, so this, when you say chitin, let's start first with the calcium carbonate. So these are the calcium carbonate we have in our mollusk, okay, mga seashells natin. Okay, and then for our insects or arthropods, then the crustaceans, we have the chitin. And the chitin is a polysaccharide. Okay, so yan yung mga bony structure nila. Actually, pag when you say polysaccharide, very thick yan at strong din, no? Okay, yan yung mga exoskeleton na, though wala naman silang bones, di ba? We know that invertebrates, they lack the backbone. Okay, meron naman silang exoskeleton.
They need support.
Okay, yes. All right. So, let's go to the endoskeleton. And then when we say endoskeleton, these are the bony structures found internally. At ayan yung i-discuss natin ngayon. Okay, so let's classify bones. Okay. So bones could be specifically for the vertebrates, no? So in terms of location, we can classify bones and in terms of that one. So first is axial. Okay, so axial can be located in the median axis of the body. So sa gitna, no? And these are the skull, our hyoid bones. So yung hyoid bone natin, this is a small bone that supports the tank. Okay, nandito yan, no? Para hindi mag-flop yung tank natin. And then we have the vertebral column that covers the spinal cord. Then we have the sternum, the breastbone, and the ribcage. Okay, so when you say axial, nasa median axis lang siya, nasa gitna. Okay, next, in terms, again, in terms of the location pa rin, we have naman the appendicular, and this can be found on the lateral, yung mga sides of the body, such as the arms and our legs. So we have the girdles. So meron tayong two types of dalawang classification ng girdles. The pectoral girdle, so ayan yung collarbone natin, no? Tutor Easter, ang ating shoulder blade. Okay, and then meron tayong pelvic girdle, okay, yan sa hip bones. Then we have the four limbs, yun yung sa upper arm and forearm. Then we have the hind limbs, okay, sa legs naman and sa hips. Ayan, so ayan yung in terms of location. Then we can further classify bones based on their shapes. Okay, so we have the long bones. And when you say long bones, the shape is, of course, elongated and cylindrical. And ang example natin dyan, be the humerus, ito.
Femur.
Yeah, the femur, which is the longest, okay, and the strongest bone in the body. We have the tibia fibula, we have the radius ulna. Okay, so usually pagka long bones, the main function is for the support and movement. Okay, and then we have the short bones. So the shape is small and cube, and their lengths and widths are about equal. Ano ba yung mga example natin dyan? Yung wrist bone natin, we call that the carpals. And then dito din sa paa, sa ankle. Okay, the tarsals. Okay, and then we also have irregular bones such as the vertebral column. Ayan. So magkakaiba yan ng shape kung titingnan natin yan, kung aaralin nyo in your higher biology na siguro sa college, aaralin nyo yung parts ng vertebral column, iba-iba talaga siya. No? Irregular ang shape. Okay, and then we also have round bones, circular in shape. Ang example natin dyan yung kneecap. Okay, so sa ating tuhod, or we call that the patella. And then we also have the flat bones, plate-like with broad surfaces, ang ating skull. Okay, so pinapahawak ko lagi yan sa aking mga students, flat ba or pabilog? Diba? So sa mga nagmo-modeling, nagpapatong sila ng book, diba? Marami yan, tapos maglalakad sila. So dapat talaga, ayan, flat bones talaga ang ating skull. Okay, so let's go now to the components or parts of ng ating skeleton. So first, we have the tendon. And the tendon attaches our muscle to the bone. Okay, so ito yung muscle natin. Okay, so we have this muscle. And then we have this bone. And itong tendon na to, this is, we call that the tendon. And then the largest tendon that we have is what you call the Achilles tendon. Ito naman yung nagkoconnect sa ating calf muscle. Okay, and then sa ating ankle, okay? We call that the gastrocnemius muscle to our ankle bone. And usually, you know, 2-3 years, nagkakaroon ng injury yung mga players natin, especially sa basketball, napuputol yung Achilles tendon nila or tendon of Achilles, na ang nangyayari ay umaangat yung muscle, di ba? So, this is a connective tissue naman si tendon, and we all know that the connective tissue, pwede siyang mag-heal because marami siyang blood supply. And then we have also the ligament. And ligament naman connects bone to another bone. Okay, at ang isa naman dyan nating example would be the ACL or the anterior cruciate ligament. Ito rin is prone to injury. Yan, usually kapag tumatalo na mataas or mali ang pagbaba, no, pagtalon, tas pagbaba ay napuputol. Okay, so prone din siya to injury ang ating mga athletes. Okay, so nagkakaroon ng ACL injury. And then, through operation din naman, nag-heal, pero it will take long time. Okay, so aside from our league,
Diba, yung ating mga sports po na mga tao, na mga, ano po, ay nagagawa, nag-wear ng mga support knee.
Yes,
support. Okay. And then yung hand support, so meron mga ganun to protect.
Yes, correct yan. Correct yan, Tutor Easter. Okay, next, aside from the ligament and tendons, we also have cartilage. And cartilage is a flexible connective tissue. So it also wraps the end of the long bones. Okay, so kung titingnan natin, at the end of every long bones, meron tayo mga cartilage. Okay. So it's not as hard and rigid as the bone, but it is stiffer and less flexible than muscle. Okay, so I know you discussed already the types of cartilages. Okay, meron tayong mga iba't ibang types of cartilages. Okay, so let's go now to bone cells. And this picture shows us a bone cell or bone cells under a microscope. So itong black na yan, we call that the Haversian canal. Okay, and then as you can see, no, madaming blood vessel running in our bones. Okay, so kaya kapag may fracture, kapag may breakage na ng bone, and then iaano lang, no, parang ikakast, and then eventually mag-heal din. Okay, kasi maraming blood vessel, maraming blood supply sa atin. Okay, so there are two types of bone cells. No, we have the osteoclast, which is responsible for secreting the matrix or producing the matrix. And then it's the opposite. Now, we have the osteoclast that performs bone reabsorption. So, ito naman ay nagbe-breakdown. Okay. So, there are instances wherein, this is another yin and yang, no, na process sa ating body, no, Tutor Easter. But, if it's in balance, no, wala tayong magiging problem. Kasi may one that is secreting and one that is responsible for breakdown. But, there are instances wherein one increases over the other. So, doon tayo nagkakaroon ng problem. And yung main problem nga niyan, Tutor Easter, no, when a woman reach its menopausal stage, di ba? So, nagkakaroon na ng imbalance sa ating mga bone cell, and it will lead to what we call the osteoporosis. Di ba? ba? So yun yung condition we're in. Osteo means bone, porosis, porous na yung bones, meaning nagwi-weaken na yung ating buto. Okay, so kung nakakita tayo ng mga matatanda, no? Not necessarily senior citizen, kasi ibang mga senior citizen talagang matalakasan. Kaya yung nagkakaroon ng hunchback or talagang lumurupok na yung bones. Kaya ito yung time na pinag-i-intake na tayo ng calcium. Alright, Tutor Easter?
Yes po, Tutor Tina. Actually, I have that condition. Osteoporotic na yung bone ko. So, ibig sabihin, wala nang laman ng calcium yung aking mga bones. So, I'm danger of having accidents. Kaya talagang bawal sa accidents in order to avoid fracture. Tutor Tina, i-ano ko lang natin, batiin lang natin, yung share lang natin, o sabihin lang natin yung sinabi ni Sir Romel, dyan, Lampas, Abale, na naalala ko, nung second year, may biology class daw sila sa science, pinalitan ng liris ng kanilang my toes, my knees, at ginawang part ng skeletal system, which is frontal, scapula, phalanges, humerus. Which is a very nice song, di ba, Tutor Tina?
Yes, oo. So, talagang sa klase, kinapa-count yung number of bones, okay, but here, no. So, in total, no, we have 206 bones, 80 for our actual skeleton and 126 in our appendicular. And a little trivia lang, no, that babies, newborn babies, they have more bones than adults. It's because hindi pa sila nag-undergo ng calcification. So, kumbaga, sa atin, no, isang bone lang, pero sa baby, it is complete. 3 or more bones pa sa kanila. So, mas marami sila, 300 plus compared sa atin. Okay, so hello sa aking kumpare tutor Romel. Okay, nanonood. Ayan, so, ayan, kabisado niya na rin yung parts. Ay, maganda nga yun na aralin talaga yung name. Bones. Okay, so let's continue, Tutor Easter. So let's go now to muscles. Okay, so we are done with the skeletal system. So ayun nga, as I mentioned, hindi na tayo mag-numerology, hindi na tayo magka-count, and also the names, no, nandun na naka-flash na sa ating name, ang mga names ng bones. So let's go to muscles. So muscles, we have three types of muscles in our body. So the first one is smooth muscle. So smooth muscles, these are the muscles that can be found in the linings of the hollow organs of the body, so internal organs specifically, such as stomach, our small intestine, okay, so sa mga inner linings of the blood vessel, and these muscles are said to be involuntary, okay, so meaning we do not have control or unconsciously these are moving or these are, may nagkakaroon ng movement, yan, no, kung nagkakaroon ng contraction or shortening na, without our control. Okay, so we cannot say na mag-stop na mag-digest ang ating stomach and so on, or mag-absorb ang ating small intestine, because these are done to us automatically. Okay, so ating autonomic nervous system siya, naka-innervate. Okay, so let's go now to another type. We also have the cardiac muscle. So cardiac muscle, if we try to compare it with the smooth, this one, kung titingnan natin under microscope, there are striations or there are also lines. And these are found from the name itself, no, cardiac, found in the walls of the heart. Okay? And then responsible for the contraction of the heart. And same with our smooth muscle, no, Tutor Easter. This is also involuntary. Okay, so we cannot control the beating of our heart. Okay, beat fast, beat slow, we cannot do that, diba? But, yeah, these are done automatically for us. Body. And then next, we have the skeletal muscles. So, ayan, kung titingnan natin, merong mga lines talaga, very obvious yung mga lines. And this is what we call the striations. And then marami ding, we also have numerous mitochondria in our skeletal muscles. It's because we know that mitochondria is the site for cellular respiration. Since nangangailangan ng maraming energy yung skeletal muscles compared to the other parts, mas marami siyang mitochondria. And from the name itself, no, skeletal muscle, because these are the muscles that attach to our bones. And this cause a lot of movements. At ito lang yung voluntary ang control, unlike the cardiac and the smooth. Nakalagay dito, almost all skeletal muscles, because not all skeletal muscles are voluntary ang control. So we have the example, yung ating diaphragm that controls the beating, the breathing, okay? So we can actually control our breathing. Most of the time, we cannot, because let's say here, as of the moment, I'm talking, but at the same time, I'm breathing. Okay, but we can control it. Let's say, I will hold my breath for about 1 to 2 minutes, okay, no? And then, di ba yung mga batang nagta-tantrums, di ba? They can hold their breath ng ganun. Pero, eventually, di ba, our body will signal na you are lowering na kailangan mo nang mag-breathe. So, meron siyang, the diaphragm itself, we can control it voluntarily and involuntarily. But most of our skeletal muscles, yan, voluntary and control. So meaning, we can, if we want to bend our arm, nakita ba ayan, and then if we want to extend our arm, if we want to stand, if we want to run, yan, so meron tayo. Consciously, we do have control of those movements. Okay? So, how do our muscles work? So meron tayo dito example, no? Our triceps, yan, so mga pina-flex natin yung triceps, and then on the back side of our arm, we have the triceps. Okay, so here, when we say contract, the muscle contract, it means it's shortened. So actually, this is antagonistic types of muscle. Kasi when the bicep contract, okay, no, when we try to bend our arm, okay, yung triceps naman natin nagre-relax. Okay, but on the other hand, when we extend our arm, yung biceps naman natin yung nagre-relax. But yung triceps naman natin yung nagko-contract or nagsho-shorten. Okay, so antagonistic movement yan ng ating muscle. So meron pang mga iba, pero yan yung usual na example. Okay, so aside from that, no, our muscle has two attachments. We have the origin. Okay, ito, naka-attach siya dito sa O, the origin. And we also have the insertion. Okay, so para saan ba? So, si origin, this is the attachment that tends not to move. Okay, so hindi nagmo-move. And then we have the insertion, the end that moves when the muscle contracts. So, same thing, our example, when we try to bend our arm, ay, hindi nakita sa camera, ayan, we try to bend our arm. So, yung origin natin, which is here sa ating shoulder, okay, no, hindi siya gumagalaw. Okay, but yung bone na nasa insertion natin, okay, yun yung gumagalaw. Okay, so remember that, no, the origin and the insertion. Okay, so we have also the adduction, moving the body part toward the midline. Okay, so when we try to move our arm like that, and then abduction, moving body part away from the midline. So raise your arm, okay, and then lower your arm again. Then we have the flexion, okay, so decreasing the angle between two bones. Okay, so we have the wrist bone, okay, and then we have the extension, increasing the angle between two bones or straightening the body part. Ayun yung example natin kanina, the flexion and extension. Then we have the rotations, turning a body part toward its own axis, so kapag naghuhula-hoop tayo. And then we have the circumduction, and then naman dito is moving in a circle at a joint. We try to swing our arm, okay, so same with this one, or also our leg. So, ganyan. Alright, so let's go now to plants. Okay, so plants, we all know that they do not have the skeleton. They do not have bones, they do not have cartilages, joints, and so on. But what makes them, yan yung nagsusupport sa kanila that makes them strong, okay, and rigid is what you call the cell wall. Okay, so cell wall is, we don't have cell wall in our cell. We only have, yung animals, diba, we only have the cell membrane. Pero wala tayong cell wall. And these cell walls are composed of what we call the cellulose. And cellulose is also a polysaccharide that makes up this plant cell or itong cell wall ng ating plant cell. So yung mga stems, the branches, the trunks of the large tree, these are all composed of cellulose. Kaya kung titingnan natin sila, wala man silang bones, but they are supported. Okay, they are rigid, okay, because of this one. Okay, and then in terms of the movement naman, they don't have muscle, di ba? Plants did not have muscles, but they have the motor cells, okay? In the region where the leaf connects to the stem. And then, yung example natin last time, they can respond to different stimuli, so they can move. So, ang alam natin ng plants, they are rooted, di ba? They are planted and it stays there, no? Hanggang mula seedling hanggang sa lumaki na sila, nandun lang sila. But the leaf and the stems can be able to move in response nga sa ating different stimuli. Okay, so example natin would be yan, no? So, ang ating mimosa pudica or what you call the makahiya. And we also have the Venus flytrap. Okay, but they are planted, no? They are rooted. But they can respond to different stimuli. Okay, so there you go. No, those are yan ang ating musculoskeletal system of both plants and the animals. So for our sci-fact of the week, so kilalang kilala natin po, no, na sana all si Miss Heidi Lynn Diaz that became the first or the Philippines' first ever Olympic gold medalist, winning in the women's 55 kilogram category. So ang binuhat niya, Tutor Easter, no, about 227 kilogram. Ganun yung total na nabuhat niya sa yung naginanap sa Tokyo 2020. Okay, so ang weightlifting, Tutor Easter, may mga different categories yan, ano, kung depende kung ano yung goal natin. If we want muscle hypertrophy, gusto ba natin maging musculus tayo? Okay, so ayan yung ganito yung kay Hydrin Diaz. Meron ding muscular power, mabilisan lang yung pagbuhat natin, no, yung weight lift natin in a very short time lang yun. So power ang mini-measure. And then we also have the muscle endurance. Ito naman longer time, how long mo ma-endure yung weight na yun, di ba? And then we have the other one, ito naman at a very short time, kung ano yung pinakamabilis mong time, pinakamabigat mong mabubuhat, o pinakamabigat na weight in a very short time. Okay, so ang yan ang ating sci-fact of the week. And of course, ito ha, Bi-Star students, nag-undergo ng maraming training si Heidi Lynn. Yes, di ba? Hindi lang yan. At sige, magtatry ako magbuhat ngayon kasi gusto rin manalo. So nag-undergo siya ng napakaraming training. Okay, so there you go. So let's see na kung may natutunan ba ang ating mga BioStar students sa ating discussion for this week. So let's have the knowledge check, Tutor Easter.
Siyempre, Tutor Tina, maraming natutunan ng ating mga BioStar students. Sabi nga, walang nakukuha sa madali ang bagay. Kaya kailangan sila ay mag-undergo ng knowledge check natin. So number one, Tutor Tina. So, which of the following is a primary function of the musculoskeletal system? A. Transmit electrical signals. B. Support and move the body. C. Transmit nutrients throughout the body. D. Filter blood and maintain electrolyte balance. BioStar students, please type the number 1 and your and the letter of your answer in the chat box. A. So, we have an answer from Elena. B from Lutiva, Mr. Lutiva. B from Hana. Letter B from Jemuel. Letter B. Is it letter B by Tutor Tina? Yes.
Yes, correct. Support and move the body. Let's go to number 2, Tutor Easter.
Number 2, which structure connect bones to bones and hold joints together? A, muscle. B, tendon. C, cartilage. D, ligaments. BioStar students, write number 2 and your answer. Is it muscle, tendons, cartilage, ligaments? So we have here another answer from Elena. Bilis-bilis talaga ni Miss Elena. So letter D from Jerwin, letter B from Russell, letter B from Iverson, letter D. Okay, so this is letter D.
Okay, the correct answer is ligament. Okay, napakabilis ng internet connection ni Elena. Okay, number 3.
Okay, number 3, which muscle type is correctly matched to its location? A, cardiac muscle to heart. B, smooth muscles to bones. C, skeletal muscles to intestines. D, voluntary muscles to stomach. Type number 3 and the letter of your answer.
Okay,
so we have an answer here from Glidel, letter A. Okay,
Okay,
from Elena, letter A. From Christian, letter A. Is it letter A? Yes, tutor.
yes, the
Vice
correct answer
President,
is.
letter A. Okay, number four. A person's body is unable to move food through the digestive system. According to diagram, which muscle is not working properly? A, muscle A. B, muscle B. C, muscle C. D, muscle A and B. Okay, so type your answer. Number four and the letter of your answer, BioStar students.
Okay, digestive system ha, is not working properly. So, ano kaya? Muscle A,
so
B,
there is an
or
answer
C?
From Miss Golasinda, letter C. From Miss Elena, letter C. From Hannah, letter C. So, what is the answer, Tutor Tina? Yes,
okay.
Very good ang ating mga BioStar students, letter C. Correct sila. So, number five. Which of the following make up the cell wall of plants? A, lipid, B, starch, C, protein, D, cellulose. By star student, type number 5 and the letter of your answer. Is it lipid, starch, protein, cellulose? Okay, again, from Miss Elena, letter D.
Okay. So the correct answer is yes, of course, it's letter D, cellulose. Okay, very good ang ating mga BioStar students. Ang bibilis.
So,
okay.
For our mahusay output of the week, we have from Horacio de la Costa High School, Ayla Golasinda and Gian Soriano, Ariza Brenica and Arian Saavedra, and Michael Lotiva and Aliyah Venus from the same school.
Okay, very good. No, ang gaganda ng kanilang poster on how to take care of our respiratory system. Okay, so another task naman no, for our bio task this week. Please research about the musculoskeletal system of a vertebrate animal. And then please make or creative representation of it using recyclable or indigenous materials. Ayan, so ipakita nyo ang inyong creativity sa amin next week. Please submit your output, pakipicturean na lang, no, or kung yung if you want to video it, kahit mga 1 minute lang, no, sa, and send it to Itulay General Biology 2 with Tutor Easter and Tutor Tina, aming official Facebook page, until June 10, 2022.
Yes.
Ay, makita ang kanilang
yeah,
mga
let's
gawa.
Go recycling, no? Recycling naman tayo ngayon. And our reference for our discussion this session, these are our references. Yeah.